So welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about my current lineup of mists and hydrating toners. As you can see here, this is my current lineup in a Boxwalla beauty box. So this is what it looks like in my bathroom on my shelf. This video was inspired by @LenaNatLife. She is one of my green beauty buddies on Instagram. I love her. And if you don't already follow her, I will put her name down here below so that you can follow her. She DM'd me recently asking me what my favorite toners are, essences, hydrating mists. And I realized that, or she actually asked me if I had a recent video where I talk about my favorite toners and mists. And I realized that I hadn't done one recently. So she inspired me to do this video here today. I thought it was a great idea. So thank you, Lena, for that suggestion. And so these are the ones that I have currently going. I realize I don't really have any essences per se that I'm using. I do have the Yuri Pubu one, the Ampoule that I have mentioned many times on my channel. I mentioned it recently because it was in either my 2017 or 2018 favorites. And I just revisited those in a recent video if you want to check that out. I'm not going to talk about it here today, even though I do have it in my rotation because I'm pretty sure it's being discontinued. I could only find it in one place, and that was on Amazon, and they had a limited amount that's available, so I'm pretty sure it's going to be hard to get. So I'm not going to talk about that today. So I just have hydrating mists and toners to talk about. So let's jump right in. The first one I'm going to talk about, sadly, I'm so sad about this because it's been discontinued. So this is the Live Botanical Calming Elixir. And the reason why this has been discontinued is because Carolyn, the creator of Live Botanical, has just relaunched her line. So I'm going to insert a picture here for you all to see the product that is going to be replacing this. And so I'm not going to talk too much about this because this is no longer available. It's being replaced by the Seasonal Radiance Elixir. And from what I can gather from the website is that this is, like the name says, it's going to be a seasonal elixir. So right now this is an autumn blend. It's going to have rose and tulsi in it. It's also got a mushroom complex in it. So even though I'm very sad that this is going away, the lavender and violet calming elixir, because I absolutely love this. You know, if you've watched my videos, you've heard me talk about this several times, but I am actually very excited to see what Carolyn has come up with. I'm really excited to try her new product, the Seasonal Radiance Elixir. It still is going for $48 for 100 ml. I think that's a fantastic price. So I'm really excited to see what she's done. So sadly, this one that now is in my current rotation is going away. So I'm going to savor every last drop of this. But again, I am really excited to see what she's doing with the product that is going to be replacing this. The next one that I'm going to talk about that's in my rotation, and I did mention this in my last video, in my What's New in PR video, this is the Ayelet Pomp. This is the hydrating toner. Such a gorgeous color. This is also the same price as the Live Botanical Elixir. This is $48 for 100 ml. I think this is a great price. As I mentioned in the last video, this has inulin prebiotic in it, niacinamide, strawberry and watermelon extracts, and hyaluronic acid. I'll just give you a little example of this mist. It's not super fine. This mist, on the other hand, is very fine. So I'm hoping that the new one that Carolyn comes out with still remains to be a very fine mist. That's one of the reasons why I love this one so much. This one, on the other hand, not a super fine mist. So actually what I do tend to do is spray it in my palms first and then I apply it on my face. But I love the scent of this. It is super hydrating. I love that it has hyaluronic acid in it. I love that it has niacinamide in it. And the scent is really, really beautiful. I love that you get the sense of the fruit extracts in here. I don't really get so much watermelon in here. I get more of a slight sense of the strawberry, and it also has an overarching scent of rose. I don't think I mentioned that in my previous video. This has become a new favorite of mine. I really, really enjoy it. Very impressed by the Ayelet line, so I do highly recommend this. Another new favorite is the Malaya Hydrating Mist Refresh and Renew. I also mentioned this in my PR video. I've been using this quite a bit. This one is a little bit more expensive, as I mentioned in that last video. It's $58 for 60 mils. This has This has rose, jasmine, and neroli hydrolots in it. There's also hyaluronic acid in here. I could also see this becoming a new favorite of mine as well. I also have the Jordan Samuel Hydrate the Mist. This is a very cost-effective product. This is $29 for 120 ml. The ingredients aren't quite as botanically driven as the three previous ones that I have mentioned. Rather than a hydrolot being the first ingredient, water is the first ingredient in this product. There's also glycerin in it. I think that's the second ingredient. There is hyaluronic acid in here. There's cucumber extract in here. There are more of the clean synthetics in this product, so you're gonna wanna read the ingredient list to make sure that you're okay with the ingredients in here. I'm totally fine with them. I really do love this mist. It's not a very fine mist. It's kind of comparable to the Ayolette one, and this one too is not super fine either. I would say in terms of all of these that I've mentioned so far, the Live Botanical has the finest mist. This one I do also tend to spray it in my hand and then I press it onto my face. It is a really effective hydrator. Like I said, I think if you're looking for something that is a little bit more cost effective, I would highly recommend the Jordan Samuel Hydrate the Mist. I do not like the scent of cucumber. I think I've mentioned that several times on my channel. I do not get any kind of scent of cucumber in here, so that is a huge plus for me. And yeah, I just think it's a terrific product. I highly recommend it. And as you guys know, I'm a huge Jordan Samuel fan. I think it's a wonderful line. I think there's something for everybody in this line. And I really love the fact that it is very affordable, especially in this green, clean skincare realm. I also have the Hanua Hawaiian Beauty Water. I actually don't know if I've ever spoken about this product on my channel. Now, as you can see, it's got a pump. So this is definitely made to pump into your hand and then press onto your skin. This is the 4 ounce size, and the 4 ounce is $42 or 120 mil. It also comes in the 2 ounce size, which is $24. This has coconut water in it, rose hydrosol. It's also got hibiscus in it, which has AHA type qualities to it. It has willow bark, Hawaiian sugar, and papaya enzyme extract in it, which all three of those together have exfoliant properties. So that gives this a unique quality to it, because I don't think in any of these other toners that I have talked about, I don't think those have any exfoliators in it. So if you're looking for something that is going to have a little bit of that exfoliant property, this is something you might want to look into. And because it does have a little bit of that treatment quality to it, this isn't one that I reach for every day, but you can see I've used a great deal of it. I really like it a lot. Having said that, in terms of it having that exfoliant quality, I don't find that it gives me any kind of tingly sensation. I feel like it's very mild, so I don't really feel like you have to worry about that if you do have sensitive skin, but I did want to just bring up that it does have those properties in it, just in case you want to either avoid that or if that is something that you want to seek out. I do think it's a beautiful product and I really, really love it. I love the Hanua line. I think that Kapua does a beautiful job with her formulations. Moving on to one that I'm not super crazy about, but I'm really trying to use this up, is the Herbivore Rose Hibiscus Face Mist. This is 4 ounces for $32. So actually it is pretty cost effective. There's, I think water is the first ingredient in here. There's also aloe in here, rose water. So for the most part, I think it is a pretty basic formulation. I do think there is hyaluronic acid in here though, so that is pretty good. One thing that I notice with it is the mist is pretty fine, but when I do spray it on my face, there's something about it that just kind of, I feel like it irritates my lungs. I don't know what it is. I don't get that sensation from any other mist I've ever used in my whole life, but when I spray it, I feel like I really notice that I inhale it and it kind of feels like it irritates my lungs. I don't know what it is, but I feel like I cough whenever I use this. So what I tend to use this for is, I've mentioned many times that when I use my Jane Iredell Pure Pressed Base and I swish it around, I swish my brush around in the pan, that I like to then use a mist to kind of moisten it up a little bit so that it gives me more of a dewy finish, and I'm make sure that it doesn't look chalky on my face. So that's what I tend to reach for this for. I don't like to put this directly onto my face, or if I am going to use this, I do spray it into my hands and then press it onto my face. So this is not a product I'm going to purchase again, just for that reason. Like I mentioned, I don't like the sensation that it gives me and my lungs. I don't know what that is all about. Leave me a comment down below if you've had that experience too, or maybe, I don't know, maybe it's just me. And then last but not least, this is the Lila B Aglow Face Mist. Now this, I wouldn't say I use this as a toner because this was created to be a makeup setting spray. This is quite expensive. This is $48 for 30 mils. I would not have purchased this if it was just going to be used as a toner because I like to use my toners very liberally. I'm not really doing the 7 skin method before. I did a video on that. So if you're curious about what that is, I will link a card up above. So I'm not really doing that whole 7 skin method anymore. I would say now I do between 3 or maybe a maximum of 5 layers of toners. I would say I do about 5. If I really feel like I need a lot of hydration, then I will pat in 5 layers of toners. But I would say I typically do about 3 now. That's about my average, I would say, pretty much every night and sometimes also in the morning. I would not have purchased a toner at this expensive of a price for that purpose. But as a setting spray, I think is really, really great. And I don't really use setting sprays every single time that I do my makeup. It's just kind of an every once in a while thing. If I do feel like my makeup is looking kind of chalky, or if my skin is feeling kind of dry and I want to kind of impart that glow back into my skin, then I will reach for this, and it really does a lovely job. It's very similar to the Tatcha glow setting spray. I can't remember the name of that. I'll put that down below. I think it's like the Dewy Skin Mist or something like that, and I was running really, really low on that, so I decided to get this, I think, during a Sephora sale. Maybe I mentioned that. I can't remember. But I do highly recommend it if you are looking for a glowy setting spray. I don't think it's a must to spend, you know, that much money on something like this. But if you want to get it during the Sephora sale, I think that's a really good time to get it. Now that I'm thinking about it, I got it with a set. So there was this one and then the travel size. And then I think there was also a gift where you got another little mini and it was also 20% off. Felt like it was very justifiable because I essentially got 50 mils of it with 20% off. So anyway, that's how I justified this purchase. So anyway, I do feel like it's a great product for what it is in terms of, like I said, imparting that dewy glow for setting your makeup if you are into that. So that wraps it up for all the hydrating toner slash mist that I have got going right now. I am really, really loving them all. I think they all serve a great purpose. I would say for cost effectiveness, Jordan Samuel is definitely the way to go. I think it's a fantastic product. Again, it doesn't really have all those botanicals high up on the ingredient list. So if that is something that you're really looking for, then I would definitely choose the Ayelet Pomp. In terms of price, I don't really think you can beat that. I'm sad to say that my precious Live Botanical Calming Elixir is no longer available, but I'm really looking forward to trying the Seasonal Radiance Elixir. I'm really looking forward to seeing what Carolyn has created, but I haven't used it myself, but I'm sure that what she has created is exquisite because I pretty much love everything that Carolyn does. So I'm sure I'm gonna be trying it in the near future, and I will definitely let you know what I think about it. So if you wanna let me know what your favorite hydrating toners and mists are, please leave that down below. If you do have an essence that you are particularly in love with, I would be more than thrilled to hear what your recommendations are. But I think about it, the reason why I don't have any essences in my lineup right now is because I've kind of been creating my own essences by mixing up these hydrating toners with serums, and then I kind of create my own little essence. I've been doing a lot of like mixology lately, sort of mixing up serums with toners and serums with emulsions. So I've been really into mixing up products lately, and maybe what I'll do for my next video is show you what I've been mixing and kind of these new creations that I've been making, and show you what my favorite new creations have been. That might be kind of interesting. So if you're actually interested in that type of a video, let me know down below. And if you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed, you know that I would appreciate that so much. And thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.